Most Filipinos are following minimum health safety protocols over a year into the COVID-19 pandemic. That's according to the latest Social Weather Station survey. The data showed 75% are still wearing face masks, 67% wash their hands regularly, and 58% observe physical distancing. The numbers hardly changed from the previous study done in September last year. But the biggest movements are in the regions, which are now experiencing a surge in infections. Face mask use in Visayas is down by 14 points from 86% to 72%. And Mindanao, now only seeing a 64% compliance from last year's 78%. The number of those practicing social distancing and those washing their hands frequently in those areas also went down. The survey was done from April 28 to May 1. 200 respondents nationwide.
The Philippine government looks to scale back COVID-19 restrictions in the National Capital Region and nearby provinces. This on the back of better healthcare utilization rates and decreasing number of infections. The COVID-19 Interagency Task Force is expected to announce new guidelines today.
Based on the figures, Metro Manila Plus might be looking at a de-escalation. It might not be to MGCQ, but it could be to ordinary GCQ because ang GCQ po natin ngayon ay meron pang mga restrictions.
But while some areas are posting improved COVID-19 figures, Western Visayas is experiencing the opposite. The chief of the infectious disease cluster in Region 6 says cases have risen by 1,000%. The uptick mostly seen in ports of Negros Occidental, Antique, Panay, and Bacolod City.
One of the things that we suspect is really pag-move ng mga tao across islands and across regions po. So may mga umuwi din po talaga tayong mga cases from Metro Manila na mga returning residents and even mga travelers.
The surge in cases in Palawan has prompted Vice Governor Dennis Socrates to place the province under a state of calamity. The provincial government says it needs to use its emergency and quick response funds to address the rising infections. People going to Palawan will also be required to undergo a 7-day quarantine upon arrival until the end of June. As of June 9, Palawan has more than 2,500 COVID-19 cases, 620 of which are active.
Nationwide, the Philippines reported over 7,000 new cases on Thursday, the highest so far this month. The country's total caseload now nearing 1.3 million. 122 more fatalities were also confirmed, pushing the death toll to 22,312. Recoveries, meanwhile, breached 1.2 million after authorities recorded an additional 4,500 today. The Philippines' COVID-19 vaccination drive gets a shot in the arm with the arrival of some 2.2 million additional Pfizer jabs. The second shipment from the American drug maker arrived at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Thursday night, courtesy of the COVAX vaccine sharing facility. The government says Cebu and Davao will receive 210,600 doses each, while the remaining doses were allotted for the capital region. Based on COVAX's requirements, the Pfizer shots will be allocated for individuals belonging to the top three priority groups. A million more Sinovac doses were also delivered to the Philippines Thursday morning.
The Philippines' police chief, Guillermo Elazar, orders a review of the cases filed against a businesswoman in connection with the alleged sale of COVID vaccine slots. Police had tagged Colorette Cosmetics CEO Nina Elaine Cabrera as one of the three suspects involved in the scheme. But Cabrera denied that allegation in an interview with ANC's Head Start.
I saw a for sale post online and then I inquired and then I found out that they were actually selling not vaccines but vaccine slots from LGUs. So what I did was I took it to Twitter. Nobody ever reached out to me, which is why I was really surprised when I saw the article yesterday. Nobody asked me questions or asked me anything about it.
After hearing her side of the story, Elazar said he tasked his office's criminal investigation and anti-cybercrime groups to check for possible lapses in their probe. If there were any, he assured Cabrera that they would make the necessary corrections.